Let's continue in the tafsir of Surah An-Nisa in the fifth juzu. The author says, starting with the word of God Almighty, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ألم تر إلى الذين أوتوا نصيبا من الكتاب يشترون الضلالة. Do you not know, Muhammad, those who are given a share of the Torah book, purchasing misguidance? They take misguidance for guidance by choosing to stay Jews after the obviousness of Muhammad's prophethood. وَيُرِيدُونَ أَن تَضِلُّوا السَّبِيلِ. And they want for you believers to stray from the way, to be like them. They want for you believers to be like them. وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِأَعْدَائِكُمْ. And Allah knows better about your enemies than you do. وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَلِيًّا وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ نَصِيرًا. And sufficient is Allah as a guardian. And sufficient is Allah as a defender from their scheme. مِنَ الَّذِينَ هَادُوا. From those who were Jews. يعني ألم تر إلى الذين أوتوا نصيبا من الكتاب. Do you not know of those who are given a share of the book? من الذين هادوا. From those who were Jews, يعني amongst those who were Jews. يحرفون الكلمة عن مواضعه. Perverting the words revealed in the Torah about Muhammad's description from their places. Or the way to explain this as, from those who are Jews are a folk who pervert the words from their places. Yani, what's the difference there? According to the way I read it to you, this part, mina ladina hadu, from those who are Jews, is connected back to something before it, even though it's the beginning of this ayah. And you could explain it another way, so that mina ladina hadu is connected to what's after it. Mina ladina hadu yuharrifuna al-kalima amma wadi'ihi. مِنَ الَّذِينَ هَادُوا يُحَرِّفُونَ الْكَلِمَ عَن مَّوَاضِعِهِ. From those who are Jews are people perverting the words revealed in the Torah about Muhammad's description from their places. Perverting those words from their places. وَيَقُولُونَ سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا. And if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam commanded them, they say, we hear what you say, and we disobey your command. وَاسْمَعْ غَيْرَ مُسْمَعْ. And they say, hearken, yani, listen, or hear, hear. Hearken, may you not be made to hear. This is a word with a double meaning. This is a word with, or a statement with a double meaning. A dispraise that they intended. Yani, the double meaning is a dispraise that they intended, or yani, it has the angle to it is a dispraise that they intended, which was a supplication against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that they were saying, may you be made deaf. This is a word with a double meaning. One meaning is a dispraise that they intended. May you be made deaf. And the other meaning is a praise that they showed outwardly as if this is what they mean without intending it though, which is, may you not be made to hear anything disliked. Those are the Jews. يَقُولُونَ سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا. And if the Prophet commanded them, they say, we hear what you say and we disobey your command. وَاسْمَعْ غَيْرَ مُسْمَعْ. And they say, hearken, may you not be made to hear. وَرَاعِنَا. And they say ra'ina, ra'ina. If this is an Arabic word, it means wait for us. And if it's not an Arabic word, then it's a piece of a Hebrew or a Syrian word that's used for insulting. لَيَّمْ بِأَلْسِنَتِهِمْ وَطَعْنًا فِي الدِّينِ. Twisting the word with their tongues and taunting the religion. وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا وَاسْمَعْ وَانْظُرْنَا لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ وَأَقْوَمْ. And had they said instead, we hear and we obey. And had they said, hearken and wait for us, it would have been better for them and more straightforward. Yani, it wouldn't have been double-crossing, backstabbing, indirect, offensive things.
وَلَكِنْ لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ بِكُفْرِهِمْ فَلَا يُؤْمِنُونَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا.
But Allah has cursed them for their unbelief, so they do not believe but little.
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ آمِنُوا بِمَا نَزَّلْنَا مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا مَعَكُمْ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا مَعَكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ نَقُمِثَ وُجُوهًا فَنَرُدَّهَا عَلَىٰ أَدْبَارِهَا.
All those who were given the book, believe in what Quran we have revealed, verifying what you have of the Torah, before we remove the contours of faces and make those faces become like the backs of their heads. Yani, Allah Ta'ala has the power to, yani, to make your face look like the back of your head. That means to remove the contours of your faces. Because your face has, yani, you know, it's obvious. Your face has the shape, eyes, nose, and lips, and cheeks, and chin. These contours, Allah has the power to remove them. So, yani, until your face resembles the shape of the back of your head.
أَوْ نَلْعَنُهُمْ كَمَا لَعَنَّا أَصْحَابَ السَّبْتِ.
Or we curse them by deformation, as we cursed the violators of the Sabbath.
وَكَانَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ مَفْعُولًا.
And the command of Allah shall be executed.
إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ.
Surely, Allah does not forgive the association of anything with Him. He does not forgive blasphemy after death. He doesn't forgive any kind of blasphemy after death, including shirk. He does not forgive this association of anything with him after you die. If you die as a kafir, as a pagan, he will never forgive you.
وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ.
And he forgives what is less than that for whomever he wills, including the major sins, even without repentance. Allah, He forgives major sins even if the one who has them did not repent from them. Ya'ani, this ayah proves that all sins less than blasphemy are eligible for forgiveness from someone who did not die as a blasphemer. If a believer died with major sins, it is possible that Allah forgives him of all of his major sins, even if he never repented.
وَمَن يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ افْتَرَى إِثْمًا عَظِيمًا.
ومن يشرك بالله فقد افترى إثما عظيما. And whoever associates anything with Allah, he has fabricated a great sin.
أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ يُزَكُّونَ أَنفُسَهُمْ.
Do you, Muhammad, not know those Jews who validate themselves by claiming to be God's children and God's beloveds? They claim to be God's children and God's beloveds.
بَلِ اللَّهُ يُزَكِّي مَن يَشَاءُ.
Rather, Allah validates, purifies whom He wills by faith. يعني, He purifies by faith whom He wills.
وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ فَتِيلًا.
And they shall not be wronged the amount of dirt that falls from between the fingers. That's very little. Not even that much injustice would they suffer from Allah.
انظر كيف يفترون على الله الكذب وكفى به إثما مبينا.
Look at how they fabricate the lie against Allah. And sufficient this is as a clear sin. Huyay ibn al-Akhtab, Ka'b ibn al-Ashraf, and a party of Jews went to Mecca to make an alliance with the pagans to fight the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that right there is breaking the covenant of the Torah. The Torah commanded them to support the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam, not to hide his description. The pagan said to them, "You are the people of the book. You are closer to Muhammad in religion than you are to us. And to us, he is closer to you. We cannot be sure that you do not come with treachery. So prostrate to our gods so that we can feel safe about you." Then they did so, those Jews. This is what Allah exposes in the Quran. This is a miracle, one of the miracles of the Quran. Exposing this that happened between the Jews and the pagans. So those Jews, they prostrated to the idols of the pagans as a compromise. And that is how they believed in the idols and in the devil. Meaning, that's the explanation of what's coming. That they believed in the idols and they believed in the devil. And we're talking about Jews. When did Jews believe in idols and believe in the devil? Here. Then the pagans asked them, "Do we have a more guided way than Muhammad, since we are the custodians of the house, the Kaaba, and we give drink to the pilgrim, and we host the guest, while Muhammad abandoned the religion of his fathers and broke the ties of kinship and left the sacred territory?" And the Jews also, in breaking the covenant of the Torah, in breaking the covenant of the Torah, they said to the pagans, "You have a better way than, you have a more guided way than Muhammad." So Allah says,
أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا نَصِيبًا مِنَ الْكِتَابِ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْجِبْتِ وَالطَّاغُوتِ.
Do you not know of those Jews who were given a share of the book? They believe in the idols and the devil. Or, according to Jalalain,
يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْجِبْتِ وَالطَّاغُوتِ.
They believe in the two idols. One idol is called Al-Jibt and the other is called الطاغوت.
وَيَقُولُونَ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا هَؤُلَاءِ أَهْدَى مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا سَبِيلًا.
And they say, breaking the covenant of the Torah to support Muhammad and not to conceal his identity, to those pagans who disbelieved, that they, the pagans, are better guided in custom than those who believe.
أولئك الذين لعنهم الله. أولئك الذين لعنهم الله.
They are those whom Allah has cursed.
وَمَن يَلْعَنِ اللَّهُ فَلَن تَجِدَ لَهُ نَصِيرًا.
And whomever Allah curses, you shall not find for him any defender. In the next two verses, Allah describes the Jews with miserliness and envy, both of which are amongst the worst of qualities. They withhold and hoard what they have while desiring what others have.
أَمْ لَهُمْ نَصِيبٌ مِّنَ الْمُلْكِ.
Or have they a share in the dominion? This is a question posed for denial. يعني, they do not have any share in the dominion.
فَإِذَا لَا يُؤْتُونَ النَّاسَ نَقِيرًا.
But then, due to their excessive miserliness, they would not give people even a little hollow in the back of a date stone. يعني, even if they had a share of the dominion, يعني, like, even if they owned the world, they are so miserly that even if they owned the world, they wouldn't give the people even as much as the little hollow in the back of a date stone.
فَإِذَا لَا يُؤْتُونَ النَّاسَ نَقِيرًا.
The naqir could be a speck or a dot, or it's the line that's engraved in a date pit. And Allah knows best.
أَمْ يَحْسُدُونَ النَّاسَ عَلَى مَا آتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ عَلَى مَا آتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ.
Or do they envy the people for what Allah has given them from His generosity? Do they envy the people, the Prophet and the Muslims, for what Allah has given them from His generosity? Allah gave them support and victory and increasing nobility and influence. So they were envious.
فَقَدْ آتَيْنَا آلَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ.
Well, indeed, we have given the book and the wisdom to the prophetic descendants of Abraham.
وَآتَيْنَاهُمْ مُلْكًا عَظِيمًا.
And we have given them a grand kingdom.
فَقَدْ آتَيْنَا آلَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ.
We have indeed given the book, the Torah book, and the wisdom, which is preaching and fiqh, to the prophetic descendants of Abraham, like Moses and David, according to Jalalain.
وَآتَيْنَاهُمْ مُلْكًا عَظِيمًا.
And we have given them a grand kingdom, like the kingdoms of Joseph and David and Solomon. Allah tells about what the Jews know and applies that to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, meaning
أَمْ يَحْسُدُونَ النَّاسَ عَلَى مَا آتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ.
Or do they envy the Muslim people for what Allah has given them from His generosity?
فَقَدْ آتَيْنَا آلَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ.
Why are they envious over that? They know, they are familiar with prophetic descendants of Abraham receiving revealed books and being granted the wisdom. يعني they are familiar with that. And this applies to Muhammad.
وَآتَيْنَاهُمْ مُلْكًا عَظِيمًا.
And we have given them a grand kingdom.
فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ آمَنَ بِهِ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ صَدَّ عَنْهُ.
So, among them is who believed in him, or among them is who believed in it, and among them is who turned away from him, or who turned away from it and did not believe. If this refers to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then the pronoun means him. Him is Muhammad.
فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ آمَنَ بِهِ.
Some of them believed in him, Muhammad.
وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ صَدَّ عَنْهِ.
And some of them turned away from him and did not believe. Or this refers to what was revealed to Muhammad. Or it refers to the stories of the kingdoms of the previous prophets. Then, if it refers to that, then the pronoun means it.
فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ آمَنَ بِهِ.
Some of them believed in it, believed in what was revealed to Muhammad, or believed in the stories of the kingdoms of the previous prophets.
وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ صَدَّ عَنْهِ.
And some of them turned away from it and did not believe.
وَكَفَى بِجَهَنَّمَ سَعِيرًا.
And sufficient is hell as an inferno to punish those who did not believe.
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِنَا سَوْفَ نُصْلِيهِمْ نَارًا.
Surely, those who disbelieved in our signs, we shall put them in a fire to be set ablaze. We shall put them, insert them in a fire in which they shall catch fire.
كُلَّمَا نَضِجَتْ جُلُودُهُمْ بَدَّلْنَاهُمْ جُلُودًا غَيْرَهَا. بَدَّلْنَاهُمْ جُلُودًا غَيْرَهَا لِيَذُوقُوا الْعَذَابِ.
Whenever their skins are thoroughly burned.
كُلَّمَا نَضِجَتْ جُلُودُهُمْ.
يعني whenever their skins are cooked thoroughly.
بَدَّلْنَاهُمْ جُلُودًا غَيْرَهَا.
We restore that for them. Two skins. Not burned. Their burned skin shall be revived to an unburned state to be burned again and again.
لِيَذُوقُوا الْعَذَابِ.
So that they taste the severity of the torture. So, someone might think the ayah means Allah gives them new skin. And it doesn't mean he gives them new skin with the meaning that they get a skin that's different from the one that they already have. Rather, it means Allah will restore the skin that they have now so that it can cook again.
إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَزِيزًا حَكِيمًا.
Surely, Allah is undefeated in his punishment, wise in his treatment of the blasphemer.
وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ سَنُدْخِلُهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا.
And those who believed and did righteous deeds, we shall admit them into gardens beneath which flow rivers on the ground, abiding therein forever and ever. Yani, being immortals therein. Being immortals within those gardens. لهم فيها أزواج مطهرة. They have therein wives purified from menstruation and anything repulsive. They have wives there in the garden who do not menstruate. They are purified from, يعني they are purified. What does it mean they are purified? It means Allah Ta'ala makes their bodies in paradise different from their bodies in this world, such that they don't menstruate anymore. And they are purified from anything repulsive, like they don't have runny noses, nor do the men in paradise.
وَنُدْخِلُهُمْ ظِلًّا ظَلِيلًا.
And we shall admit them into perpetual blanketing shade, according to Tabari.
إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تُؤَدُّوا الْأَمَانَاتِ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهَا.
Surely, Allah commands you to hand over the trusts, the rights, to their deserving recipients, to their deserving owners. يعني if you have someone's right, like you're holding something that belongs to someone else, or you owe a person money, or you have any right over you, fulfill it.
وَإِذَا حَكَمْتُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ أَن تَحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ.
And that when you judge between people, you judge with justice, with fairness and justice. And the justice is only going to be according to Islamic law, not according to another law. If someone says to you, you are one of those people who argue for Sharia law, say to him, don't you know that a human being does not have the right to impose a law on another human being? So which law are you going to argue for?
إِنَّ اللَّهَ نِعِمَّا يَعِظُكُمْ بِهِ.
Surely, Allah, so good is that by which He admonishes you. So good is that by which He lectures you, which is returning the trusts and ruling fairly. That's such good advice.
إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا.
Surely, Allah is hearer of your sayings, seer of your deeds.
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ.
All those who believed, obey Allah and obey the messenger. That means believe in Allah and believe in the messenger. And obey those in authority among you, yani the caliph. Obey the caliph is obligatory. When those in authority among you command obedience to Allah and his messenger. And the caliph, he might appoint governors under him in different areas. All of that is going to be obedience to the caliph.
فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ.
Then, if you dispute with the authorities about something, refer it to the Book of Allah and to the Messenger if he is alive. Go to him.
إِن كُنتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ.
If the Prophet is not alive, then refer to his Sunnah if you believe in Allah and the Last Day.
ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ.
That referring back to those two sources is more advantageous than disputing and talking from opinion.
ذلك خير وأحسن تأويلا.
That is better and يعني that is more advantageous and it has a better outcome. To give the trusts to those who deserve them and to believe in Allah and His Messenger and to obey the Muslim authorities. And that when you have disputes, you refer them back to the rules of the religion. Most important. There was a dispute between Bishr the hypocrite and a Jew. So those two kuffar in Muslim society, they have a problem. The Jew suggested going to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam because he knew that he could not be bribed. Now as for the hypocrite, he's kafir, but being a hypocrite means he's showing himself as a Muslim. So looks like dispute between a Muslim and a Jew. But it's two kuffar. So the Jew suggested going to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam because he knew that he could not be bribed, as if the Jew knew that he was right here. He didn't want to get cheated out of his right, so he said, let's go to the Prophet himself. The hypocrite suggested going to Ka'b ibn al-Ashraf so that he could bribe him. They went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who judged for the Jew, and the hypocrite did not accept. So he said, yani the Jew said, well, let us go to Umar. So they went to the Prophet alaihi salatu wasallam. He judged for the Jew, the hypocrite didn't accept. So the Jew said, let's go to Umar. Yani he's setting him up here. So the Jew said to Umar, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam judged for me, and this one does not accept his judgment. So this hypocrite doesn't know what the Jew is taking him to. Umar said to the hypocrite, is that so? He said, yes. Umar said, both of you wait right here until I come back out to you. He went inside, grabbed his sword, and came out and beheaded the hypocrite. And then he said, this is how I judge for the one who does not accept the judgment of Allah and his messenger. So this means Umar ibn al-Khattab made takfir on this man based on this. He used all of this to make takfir on that man and deem him as a kafir, and then he killed him. So then it was revealed. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ يَزْعُمُونَ أَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ يَزْعُمُونَ أَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ وَمَا أُنزِلَ مِن قَبْلِكَ. Do you, Muhammad, not know those hypocrites and people of the book who assert that they have believed in what was revealed to you and what was revealed before you? They assert means they claim. Do you know about those, Muhammad?
يريدون أن يتحاكموا إلى الطاغوت وقد أمروا أن يكفروا به.
They want to summon each other to the judgment of that transgressing devil, Ka'b ibn al-Ashraf, though they were commanded to disbelieve in him and not to align themselves with him.
وَيُرِيدُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَن يُضِلَّهُمْ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا.
And the devil wants to mislead them remotely astray from the truth. Remotely astray means very far away. The devil wants to mislead them ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا. Remote straying, far away. Subhanallah wa bihamdi. That's what Shaytan's gonna do to you if you can. Get you very far. So you start piercing all your body and putting tattoos on all your body and you put implants under your skin, give you like lumps, and you inject ink into your eyes and you slit your tongue. So it looks like a snake. The Shaytan's gonna make you go that far. You're gonna be drinking blood and all kinds of stuff.
والعياذ بالله تعالى فكيف إذا أصابتهم مصيبة بما قدمت أيديهم.
So how about when disaster befalls them for what blasphemy and sins their hands have sent forth? They're taking the case to someone else and accusing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam concerning his verdict, because by not accepting the Prophet's verdict, they're accusing the Prophet and concerning his verdict, alayhi salatu wasalam. Would they be able to turn and run then, when disaster befalls them for that? And that's what happened to him. The disaster befell him for his disbelief there. Allah unleashed on that hypocrite someone who would kill him. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. ثم جاءوك يحلفون بالله إن أردنا إلا إحسانا وتوفيقا. Then they come to you swearing by Allah, we did not want anything by taking the case to someone else but to extend good by settlement and for there to be accord. And they're making excuses. There's no excuse. He's the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah. That's the difference between someone who has faith and someone who doesn't have faith. Subhanallah wa bihamdi. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُ اللَّهُ مَا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ. They are those whom Allah knows what hypocrisy is in their hearts. He knows the disease in their hearts. فَأَعْرِضْ عَنْهُمْ وَعِظْهُمْ. So turn away from them and admonish them, lecture them.
وَقُلْ لَهُمْ فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ قَوْلًا بَلِيغًا.
And say to them about themselves an effective, far-reaching statement. An effective, far-reaching statement. Tell them about themselves. It's so real. That's the Quran.
وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا لِيُطَاعَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ.
And we did not send any messenger, but so that he would be obeyed, not disobeyed, by Allah's permission, his command.
وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ إِذْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ جَاءُوا.
Had they, when they wronged themselves by taking the case to the devil, come repentant to you, O Muhammad. Had they come to you, O Muhammad, when they wronged themselves, Yani. Had they, when they sinned, came to you, O Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا اللَّهَ وَاسْتَغْفَرَ لَهُمُ الرَّسُولُ.
And they sought the forgiveness of Allah when they came to you. And the messenger also sought forgiveness for them.
La wajadu Allaha tawwaban rahima.
They would have found Allah forgiving of them and merciful to them. You heard about this ayah. This ayah is still applicable after the Prophet's death. Like if someone went to the messenger's grave.
وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ إِذْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ جَاءُوكَ.
And had they, when they wronged themselves, come to you, O Muhammad, even to his grave, alayhi salatu wasalam, that Muslim who wants to repent.
فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا اللَّهَ وَاسْتَغْفَرَ لَهُمُ الرَّسُولُ.
And then they sought the forgiveness of Allah. And the messenger sought forgiveness for them, which he does do in his grave, if you remember the hadith. Didn't the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam say, your deeds are displayed to me. If I see something good, then I praise Allah. And if I see something bad, then I seek Allah's forgiveness. Then they would have found Allah forgiving of them and merciful to them. Yani, they would have known him to be forgiving and merciful.
فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ.
So no, By your Lord, they do not believe in reality until they make you a judge in what became a dispute between them, O Muhammad. Yani, they are satisfied with what you have to say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That suffices them. They don't have to go any further.
ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِّمَّا قَضَيْتَ.
And furthermore, they do not find any burden, any annoyance, or doubt in their hearts about any ruling you gave, O Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wa sallam.
وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا.
And they submit with complete submission. So that's the case of the believer there. Subhanallah.
وَلَوْ أَنَّا كَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ أَنِقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ أَوْ اِخْرُجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ مَا فَعَلُوهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ ما فعلوه إلا قليل منهم.
And had we prescribed for them, lay down your lives. Yani, put your lives on the line for the sake of the religion. Or go forth from your homes. They would not have done it, but a few of them, those hypocrites. Because they don't love the obedience to God. Some people, they don't love to obey God. They don't like it. Imagine if there were two people. One person, Yani, the angel came to him and said to him, your Lord forbids you from this. So that one said, my Lord forbids me from this, let me refrain. And the angel said to him, your Lord commands you to do this. So he says, my Lord commands me to do that, let me hearken. And there's another one, an angel would come to him and tell him, your Lord commands you to do such and such. And he would frown. He wouldn't like it. And if the angel told him, your Lord forbids you from such and such, he would frown. He wouldn't like it. My example, I'm telling you, an angel told him that. So you can conceive how someone would not care about the obedience to God. He would rather do what he wants to do.
وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ فَعَلُوا مَا يُوعَظُونَ بِهِ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ.
And had they done what obedience to the messenger they were admonished to do, it would have been better for them.
وَأَشَدَّ تَثْبِيتًا.
And it would have been stronger for securing their certainty, for verifying their faith.
وَإِذَا لَآتَيْنَاهُمْ مِنْ لَدُنَّا أَجِرًا عَظِيمًا. وَإِذَا لَآتَيْنَاهُمْ مِنْ لَدُنَّا أَجِرًا عَظِيمًا.
And had they secured their certainty and verified their faith, we would give them from ourselves a grand unending reward of the garden.
وَلَهَدَيْنَاهُمْ صِرَاطًا مُسْتَقِيمًا.
And we would have certainly guided them a straight path. Yani, we would have guided them a right way.
وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ.
And whoever obeys Allah and the Messenger, they are with those upon whom Allah has endowed.
مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ.
Among the prophets, the especially faithful and loyal saints called the Siddiqs, the martyrs and the righteous who have not been mentioned.
وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا.
and what fine company they are to visit and to listen to and to be in their presence, although their stations in paradise are higher. يعني
وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولُ,
whoever obeys Allah and his messenger, and the messenger, يعني he's a believer. The obedience here refers to most fundamentally believing more than doing the outward acts.
فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ,
then they are with, يعني they shall be with, those upon whom Allah has endowed. So if I translate the words literally here,
فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ,
those are with, so it's like present tense, those are with those upon whom Allah has endowed. But this is in reference to paradise. So it means, now it means they shall be with. That's what it means now, because we're not in paradise. But in the afterlife, when it's live, then it's going to mean in the present. They are with, because that's how the Quran is. So there's ayahs in the Quran, they mention the future, like things that will happen in the afterlife. So you're going to look at the way it's worded, like it's past tense or something like that. Like, for example, Allah tells us about the devil.
وَقَالَ الشَّيْطَانِ, the devil said that on judgment day.
So for us now it means he shall say. And then in the afterlife, after it's over and the devil is in hell and the believers are in paradise and they're reciting the Quran, and they say,
وَقَالَ الشَّيْطَانِ,
the devil said, then it's going to be for the past because it happened already.
وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ,
those are with those upon whom Allah has endowed. Who are they?
مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ,
prophets and the Siddiqs. Siddiqs are high-ranking saints. And the martyrs, so those all the highest ranks. And the Salihin, the pious, the God-fearing, or the righteous. So,
وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا,
and what fine company they are to visit in paradise and to listen to them and to be in their presence. Although their stations in paradise are higher, you can visit them. You can go to their place in paradise, which is higher than yours. And then you're going to leave, for example, after some time, and you're still going to be happy. Because everything in paradise is so nice. SubhanAllah.
ذلك الفضل من الله وكفى بالله عليما.
That being in the company of those mentioned is the generosity from Allah, not an obligation on him. And sufficient is Allah as a knower of what reward he has in store. So trust what he tells you about it.
وكفى بالله عليما.
Allah is enough as a knower. So take his word for it.
Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu,
O those who have believed,
khudhu hidhrakum,
take your precaution, be on alert from your enemy.
Fanfiru thubatin aw infiru jami'a,
then go forth in successive detachments, one after the next, or go forth all together.
وَإِنَّ مِنْكُمْ لَمَنْ لَيُبَطِّئَنَّ,
and surely in your midst, O army of the Prophet, is certainly who indeed swears to fall back. In your midst, there is indeed someone who swears to fall back. This one who's a coward and he hurts the morale of the fighters.
فَإِنْ أَصَابَتْكُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالَ قَدْ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيَّ قَالَ قَدْ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيَّ إِذْ لَمْ أَكُنْ مَعَهُمْ شَهِيدًا.
If then misfortune of death or defeat befalls you, he says, surely Allah bestowed upon me since I was not with them in attendance. يعني saying, I got out of there and I escaped the calamity. I escaped the disaster. Allah has endowed upon me.
وَلَئِنْ أَصَابَكُمْ فَضْلٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لَيَقُولَنَّ ليقولنك أن لم تكن بينكم وبينه مودة.
And by God, if there hits you generosity from Allah like victory and spoils, he would certainly say in regret, as if there had not been between you and him any love.
يا ليتني كنت معهم.
Woe is me, had only I been with them.
كنت معهم فأفوز فوزا عظيما.
Had only I been with them, then I would have won a great triumph.
صدق الله العظيم.
Let's stop.